Hello, I'm Kristen Wright, Director of the Special Education Division at the California Department of Education. I'm here to talk with you about the new California Alternate Assessment for Science, also known as the CAA for Science. Like other California alternate assessments, this new test is designed to be administered one-on-one to allow students with the most significant cognitive disabilities the opportunity to show what they know and can do. This assessment is based on alternate achievement standards aligned with the new California Next Generation Science Standards, also known as the California NGSS. These alternate achievement standards, sometimes referred to as core content connectors, were built by EdCount, who collaborated with both California special education and science teachers. The connectors were developed to make the standards more accessible to this population of students. These alternate achievement standards include the same core principles at the appropriate levels while still maintaining the challenge and rigor of the NGSS standards. In this video, you'll learn about embedded performance tasks for science, what is unique about using these tasks to statewide testing, and you'll see a sample embedded performance task and how it works. You will also learn how to get involved in the development of the new assessment, as well as how to access resources to better prepare your students for the new test.
I'm Michelle Center, Director of the Assessment, Development, and Administration Division at the California Department of Education. The innovative design of using embedded performance tasks allows students to demonstrate their knowledge and skills in an environment that is less burdensome for the students. This means these tasks can be administered as soon as the related concepts have been introduced and taught to a student. This minimizes the gap between instruction and assessment. So what is an embedded performance task for science? Embedded performance tasks for the CAA for Science is a collection of activities and questions given immediately following the instruction on a specific concept. The testing of a concept immediately following instruction will provide teachers with feedback on their students' performance. Such feedback could be used to reteach concepts if necessary. This approach will eventually lead to performance tasks being given throughout the school year following instruction on different concepts. The CAA for Science is unique in its design because it emphasizes the importance of learning as well as student and teacher relationships by giving teachers, who know their students best, more flexibility and control over when and how performance tasks are administered. The CAA for Science seeks to strike a balance between standardization and the flexibility to fit individual student learning styles. The test administration flexibility will be showcased later in this video when we walk through a sample task.
How does an embedded performance task work? Before administering the CAA for Science, test examiners are given guidelines on how to administer the assessment. Teachers can choose when to give each performance task according to when the associated concepts have been taught to the student. In this sample item, the performance task requires students to identify physical properties of materials through various forms of observation. Test examiners can choose two different pairs of properties from the list to test. In this example, the properties are hard or soft and sink or float. Test examiners can also choose from the list of suggested materials a student can observe or write in alternate materials that are not on the list. Test examiners will then prepare exemplar observation tables or modifiable observation tables for the individual student. In this sample item, we have chosen a coin, a marshmallow, a cotton ball, and a metal paperclip. The test examiner may also select materials based upon the individualized learning style of the student, whether the student needs physical objects, or if the visual representations provided with the task are enough. The student is then instructed by the test examiner that he or she will be observing materials. The student is then asked to identify the first pair of properties. Once the observations are complete by the student, they are asked to provide their observation using the mode of communication that works best for them. The CAA for Science responses are scored using a rubric. If the test examiner uses suggested or alternative materials, These materials should be listed and correct answers must be provided. The performance tasks are not timed, and once it has been administered, test examiners cannot go back to that performance task to retest. Once the test is operational, the embedded performance tasks will be administered throughout the school year. For the upcoming pilot tests, a student survey will be administered at the end of the assessment to gather students' feedback about the test and to gather participation rates. Test examiners are also asked to complete a separate teacher survey. California will administer two pilot tests, one in spring 2017 and another in spring 2018. The CAA for Science field test will be administered in the 2018-2019 school year and will be operational for the 2019-2020 school year. Not all features on the test will be implemented until the test becomes operational. You can visit the CASP.org website to look at the sample embedded performance task and familiarize yourself with the new test. There, you will also find resources to help you and your students prepare for the new test, as well as a variety of ways for you to help develop the CAA for Science.
I can truly say for once that, you know, my kids are actually being tested on things they should be, and the standards are actually going to apply to them, and I cannot be even more excited about where this test is going to take the future of California and their educational department.